In the 2019 Italian Grand Prix, no driver got the chance to set a second flying lap in Q3.
The rest of them didn't get to the line in time to start their final flying lap.
But what if no one set any flying lap? Let's find out. So I went into a qualifying session at Monaco and parked myself at the end of the pit lane, stopping anyone from going out. And now I just had to wait for the entire qualifying session.
2,000 years later.
When the session eventually ended, Max Verstappen was on pole from Logan Sargeant, with Oscar Piastri bringing up the rear. In case you're wondering, this is because Verstappen has the lowest number on the grid, that being 1, and Piastri has the highest with 81. These results made me wonder, would it eliminate people, even if we set no time at all? I repeated the same experiment with full qualifying, and got the same order. But Hamilton, Sainz, Russell, Bottas and Piastri were all knocked out, even though no one else set a lap either. The bottom five were eliminated in Q2 as well, and I just about scraped into Q3. But then I remembered something. In real life, at the start of Q1, the order on the side column is dictated by the order of third practice. So I thought that maybe this could be a thing in F123 as well. So I enabled practice and simulated FP3. Hamilton finished fastest, from Leclerc and Verstappen in third. I performed my usual antics in qualifying, but despite having practice slots that could have been used, the game still decided the order by driver number, which means no matter what you do, if no one sets a lap in qualifying, the order will be set by driver number. So maybe you should use number 3 to gain that little advantage over your rival.